good to go.
Hey everybody, my name is Rachel and I'm going to talk to you today about the art movement, Impressionism. And so what I want to begin with is we all have impressions of the things around us, the people we come in contact with, the things we see, the things we feel, and even just, you know, coming and interacting with different people from different places. That can affect the impression we have of the world. And as Claude Monet said, try to forget what objects you have before you, a tree, a house, a field, or whatever. Merely think, here's a little square of blue, here's an oblong of pink, here's a streak of yellow, and paint it just as it looks to you, the exact color and shape, until it gives you your own impression of the scene before you. My personal credibility with Impressionism is that I've studied art history here at SPCC. I'm also studying to become an art teacher, so I'm very interested in all the art movements and learning how art through the past has affected how it becomes in the future. And I've also recreated one of Monet's paintings in my painting class.
Nice.
Impressionism is what became of a necessity for something new. People wanted to break away from the boring kind of, oh, let's just paint what we actually see, the reality. Monet especially, he wanted to make it look different than, you know, what you actually saw. He put in colors that weren't actually there to create a movement and beauty within the painting itself. So today I'm going to be defining Impressionism for you, where it originated, and the reason behind its origination, expanding on the elements of Impressionism, and also talking about the effects of the Impressionistic movement on modern art and into present day today. So defining Impressionism. The gardener's art through the ages, the Western Perspective, Volume 2, by Frederick Kleiner, published in 2015, defines Impressionism as a late 19th century art movement that sought to capture a fleeting moment, thereby conveying the elusiveness and impermanence of images and conditions. And so modernism was what was coming into the picture here. People were wanting to paint, you know, what they actually saw, and that was in the Romanticism time. And as Impressionism came, they wanted a change from that. They wanted to give the form a different feel rather than just making it solid and structured. And with political and societal issues, and with Charles Darwin's evolution theory and Communist Manifesto of Karl Marx, impermanence in the world and that being stressed was reflected in the art, as you can see. Impressionism came from the artists who rejected the academies and the salons where structured and, you know, mandatory art was displayed and taught. And so emphasis was placed on individualism, and the individualistic mindset was stressed to where, you know, paint what you want, paint it how you want, and that's going to be enough. And so that's kind of what they went for. According to Privilege's Art Forms 11th edition by Patrick Frank, published in 2014, Monet and his colleagues were dubbed impressionists by a critic who objected to the sketchy quality of their painting. Art began to become an expressive outlet for people. In Art, Visual History by Robert Cummings, published in 2015, it states that whether it was picnics, boating parties, still lifes, railway stations, city views, or sun-flooded landscapes, vibrantly alive with color, the emphasis was on the world immediately surrounding the painter. And so basically, they took their studios outside, and they did something called plein air painting, which is open air painting. They would take their canvases and their easels, and they would paint out in the actual environment, rather than just, you know, picturing it in their head and doing it inside of a building. They went out and experienced the environment that they were painting. And in this, they were affected a lot by light sources and how they portrayed their paintings depending on the time of day and weather conditions. So now I'm going to talk about the elements of Impressionism. In the Art Forms 11th edition by Patrick Frank, it explains the process as follows. From direct observation and from studies in physics, the impressionists learned that we see light as a complex of reflections received by the eye and reassembled by the mind during the process of perception. So during this time, when they would go out and they would paint, the colors that they would see were, you know, were common colors that you might think, but these artists, they would look for deeper colors, and maybe, you know, if it's a shadow, you know, we would paint black. but they would see purples and blues and deeper colors within that one little source of shadow or highlight. And as you can see here, Monet did about 30 of the same painting of this Roman cathedral. And all of these are different times of day, and you can see the color variations. And in most of these, you could probably guess at what time of day it was, probably. Could be sunset, depending on which side the sun was on, or sunrise. And with this, it could be almost dusk. And so that's how they were immersed in that. They looked for the colors within the environment that they had placed themselves in. Common elements in Impressionism. We see here, these are two of Monet's paintings. The first is the wheat field in 1881, and this is Madame Monet and her son in 1875. Basically, the artists, the Impressionists, would start with observation. They would look at what they're going to paint. They would need to look for the colors, the composition also in that. Now, they wanted to decide what they were going to include in their painting and see how it looks on the canvas, whether it makes it look off balance, and how the colors are going to react with each other. In shaping, you look at the distance that things are at, especially in this one. They needed to define the shapes of those trees, and most likely they probably they could have just painted triangles for trees or anything like that. But with the movement of the brush strokes and also the colors that they use, that's how they defined the shape of what they were painting. Movement is also shown here, especially with the direction of the brush strokes. Monet tried to capture not just the subjects in the atmosphere, but the atmosphere around the subjects. And that's something common you'll see in Impressionistic painting. Volume and mass, we see the shadow and highlights and variations of color. A lot of, in Monet's paintings, he balances it really well with the dark room here and the dark room here so that you don't feel like, something's gonna fly away or something. But that is mostly what they looked for. In space, especially with the landscape paintings, they needed to know the proportions of how they should paint it. You know, something's far off, how small should it be in comparison to what's right here in front of me? And that involves, sometimes math, and other times just, measuring with your thumb. And so that's elements that they would include. The most two important elements within Impressionistic painting is color and light. They would use pure color, and they would use big blobs of it. And you could honestly, you could stand inside an Impressionistic painting, and you could see it off the canvas about an inch. So they would just smack it on there. But that gave it a real nice texture and a reality, you could feel it. And so you felt like you were kind of in that scene. And the most, the most important thing that we see with Impressionistic painting is that up close, you just see a bunch of little colors and dabs and little strokes. But from far away, it actually makes these really solid forms and this kind of vibrating picture of color. And so, as I said earlier, painting colors that aren't actually there. For here, using blues and such for the shadow on the snow, and orange and yellow for the light. And sometimes, the colors didn't always make sense, but that was their impression of what they were seeing before their own eyes. And so light was created by the interplay of variations in color in their paintings. Impressionism and its influence. So according to Art, A Visual History by Robert Gomez, published in 2015, in seeing this as accidental, the product of the transitory light conditions and chance moments, it prompted a strikingly different pictorial language that began the overthrow of the naturalistic tradition of the Renaissance. There was heavy influence that came from the past traditions and art movements that had come before, and of course, all art is built on the foundations of what came before it, whether it be, keeping the same techniques or straying away from them. And so, as we see, quite a few important art movements came from the Impressionistic period, such as Expressionism, which Vincent van Gogh is one of the most popular artists from that time, Cubism with Pablo Picasso, and Surrealism in pop art. And that kind of leads into today's art, where it's modern and just kind of, do your own thing. It might look weird, but, it's art. So we look at how Impressionists affected the idea of how you could play with color, how you could manipulate it into forms. And so as we get art movements, that kind of carries over with experimentation with color and how to represent reality with, you know, colors that wouldn't normally be there. Psychology of representation and the expression in art. How does your spirituality and your emotion, how does your thoughts come out into the art? How does, what's the psychology behind that? And you see that especially today and in today's art. So. Impressionism was an art movement that sought a new perspective away from the monotonous nature of painting for patrons' historical recollections and the art that had preceded it. We've covered defining Impressionism and its origin, the elements of Impressionism, and how Impressionism has influenced the art movements after it. It's not just a style, but it was a movement that pushed forward the art community and the way that art is done. And so a way of seeing and thinking that has progressed into modern art now. So what is the impression of the world that you see around you?
Lovely.